Guys, it's finally here. You know what it is, right?
Yeah.
It's Ex-Aid! It's
Ex-Aid! Are you okay? I think he's having a heart attack!
Ex-Aid's here!
He's having a heart attack! We're kind of in an emergency!
No, that's not a heart attack. He's speaking in tongues! Ichi, take this Bible, start at Psalms 13, don't stop till I say, the power of Christ compels you! The power of Christ compels you!
Are you a doctor?
No. Do I look like a doctor?
Ex-Aid!
Shadowcaster's here!
Oh my god, Shadowcaster!
He just came in the door! He hasn't been here the whole time!
Doctor, what's my prognosis?
No, I have been here the whole time. You just haven't
You're ruining the bit! Keep going!
You're a bit! Okay.
Are you saying he's been diagnosed with Ex-Aid overhype?
Yep, that's what I said.
Whoa.
You're such a talented doctor!
Guys, cue the roll call!
Still think he's possessed.
Zen Kaigan
Broadcast Loading
Connect
Watching all the anime Redcaster Show Raven
Equipment Wielder Bluecaster Ishida's Azeal
Loyal and Loud Pinkcaster Lightred
Explorer from the Unknown Yellowcaster Autogar
Working behind the scenes, Shadowcaster, Ransack.
Trauma Inducer, Northcaster, Saga.
One Little Spark of Courage, Dreamcaster, Global Soft Perka.
Broadcasting loud and opinionated perspectives across the internet.
Radio Sentai Castranger.
On air!
Welcome to Radio Sentai Castranger, everybody. We got Dreamcaster. Shadowcaster's back.
Northcaster makes a comeback.
Northcaster decided to grace us with his fucking presence.
I forgot to say hi.
You're welcome.
You just said hi.
Nailed it.
Anyways, we're here to talk about the debut of Kamen Rider Ex-Aid. It's about fucking time. I'm so hyped for the show since its announcement.
Wait a minute. I thought his debut was like 2 weeks ago.
No.
The debut of his series.
His series, episode one, Uno.
Don't be such
Memento.
A stick in the mud that Wayne slipped in.
What?
Gar attempted to give my finger a blowjob. It was weird.
Wouldn't that be a hand job?
You're just obsessed today.
Gar's just confused at me. What? Anyways!
So, because we expect to be talking about Ex-Aid for quite a while, first off, there's not going to be a feature topic this week. And we're actually going to do the Zooja discussion first.
That's right, reversing it again.
Deal with it.
Y'all must hate us by now.
Deal with it.
Ooh, that was a good cracking, Kevin.
Thanks.
Sorry, we fucked up your gym schedule.
Oh no, Zoe's dead.
We need a doctor!
He just came back.
No, first, we need a zoologist.
I'm still here!
We need a different doctor!
A zoologist, in fact.
Sure. Let's talk about Zooja. So, the episode starts with a fucking pancake party for some reason.
Because
friends, Ichi!
Apparently, that's how you bond in Japan. You make pancakes.
Well, okay, before we get into that,
you bond each other to each other with pancakes as the adhesive?
Well, pancake batter is that.
Well, you can represent pancakes as Asian.
I mean,
I'm not gonna go anywhere with that.
Well, no, wait. The best pancakes are made in rice cookers, so you know.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, you're not wrong. Before we get into the episode quickly, so Shadowcaster has been watching Zooja and he's now caught up. So, Kevin, what do you think of Zooja so far?
I like it. I like it a lot.
He likes the world.
I do.
Is it better than ninjas?
Well, anything's better than that.
Thank you.
Almost. Don't actually make me say it.
Okay.
don't bring back bad memories.
I refuse to believe that I might admit that that's better than anything.
Is the reason he's Shadowcaster.
Right? no, I like the forms. I like the characters for the most part anyway.
Holy shit. Yep. I just noticed, this is the first time ever where me and Kevin are on the same episode.
Damn.
There's an item off my bucket list!
And it's the last, no.
Gar, you're fired.
Ouch.
Ouch.
But anyways.
Kevin, you're the new Yellowcaster.
Aww.
No, in fact, now you're the black and yellow caster.
The bee caster.
Bee caster.
Bucket cast.
Bucket.
Well, no, I am not going anywhere for now.
Well, now.
In case I die, I don't know.
So yeah, pancakes.
Pancakes, so friendship.
Pancakes
awkward.
Are a good food to eat with your friends because you can all make them together. You can decorate them together. You can enjoy them together. They're
we
a
have
good
five,
friendship food.
We have 5 boxes of pancakes over there. You want to make some?
Yeah, I do.
Really?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, there's like 5
pancake
boxes
party
of
after
pancake
the podcast.
Cake. Yes.
Yeah, pancake party.
And, after. I know what song we can sing while doing so. Pancakes, pancakes, eat them with a fork. Pancakes,
thinking,
pancakes, don't be a dog.
I was thinking bacon.
What's that?
Pancakes.
It's from Dave the Barbarian.
Oh,
oh
my god, I love
Steve,
that show.
Yeah.
But
Steve,
I don't
yeah.
It.
Okay, okay,
Dave,
that's fine.
Dave.
So, as everyone's probably realized, it's a heavily me-style-focused episode.
I never had pancake friends.
Wow.
Oh, no.
No, he's never had friends. He's never had pancakes with friends.
No. I know, I was making a joke.
Which implies he's had pancakes and friends, but separately.
Honestly, the way they start off this episode was hilarious. Just, Tusk is complaining to all of them. He complains to Misa, and then he's like, "Ah, shit, I forgot what happens to Misa."
You know what I loved? I loved how, like, Tusk's complaints started off genuinely right. Like, Sayla, if you put that much on, it's not gonna cook. I'm sure it will. No, it won't.
Leo, you flip too quickly.
Oh, it'll be fine.
But I want it now.
But then as it moves on, it gets less and less. Like when he says to Yamato, no, sorry, to Amu, don't let Yamato make your pancakes. You're supposed to do it yourself. And then, like, Yamato's like, dude, I'm trying to get laid.
Yeah.
Like,
right?
And it gets to me
trying to get no pussy.
Just don't you fuck this up for me.
I'm trying to get her cake.
Right? And it gets to Misao, and it's just like, dude, you're putting on way too much. You're not even going to taste the pancake. Okay, technically you're right, but Jamon, look at all that strawberry.
Maybe that's what I wanted. Maybe I don't like pancakes.
Wouldn't it be great if he had said...
I just wanted to be your friend.
Wouldn't it be great if he said, Misao, you're putting way too much stuff on that pancake. And he just goes, pancake.
I thought this was a waffle.
Power Rangers adaptation of that just... Just wait, there's supposed to be pancakes?
That's what I meant.
I thought it was just a very bland waffle.
I thought it was the plate that we're decorating.
Pancakes on.
I must say, Misao, I think, has missed his calling as like a performance chef.
Yeah.
That was very delicate.
He's the next Oren Pierre Alfonso.
Well, that's what happens when you try to impress like the people you're close to. You just want to like overdo everything. Just be like, I made this for you.
And yes, like Misao once again goes, oh, I failed.
I suck. I don't deserve to eat pancakes with all of you.
You know what? Has somebody made a compilation yet of every time Misao's just... You know.
I'm going to go ahead and say we should wait till the end of
the
show because we know there's going to be way more of those.
Yeah.
Because I think this is this show's... Thou shall not say it.
Lane say
it. Oh my.
Oh my.
No, wait, no.
This is his version of Akira's Shinibajo.
No, what was...
What was it blue in that Ninja?
Yeah, I can't remember.
Is it?
No, start up the counter!
No, I'm not doing a Misao. I don't deserve a counter.
Yes, Aisha.
Okay, fine. But then wait, Lane, your thing from the news is answered, though. Where's the swallow? There's the swallow, Mario!
Oh.
He was dressed as a swallow.
Yeah. I was the one who mentioned the swallow.
There's
a swallow.
The sound a swallow makes.
I know, that's just my generic bird noise.
Sorry, it was Ichigo.
Okay. Just he comes in a suit, and I'm like, what?
Wait, that's,
no, he's
that's
wearing
later.
A plastic suit.
I know, but I didn't know it was a swallow.
Yeah, but that's, again, that's like a waiter in the episode.
Right at the beginning.
No, it's not.
When Mario comes in?
No, that's way later. What is it? Yeah.
Anyways, it's because he's always at the
suit. Anyway, blood game back on.
Yeah.
Yay.
So who's the player for this week?
Oh, I got it.
From Team Kumar, it's Flipsider, or at least that's what the subs came out as. The
Omateria.
Hikuri Kaeru.
I really liked the design of this monster.
Oh, he had that one look on his back and then just turned around and went, oh, by the way!
When you saw him in the distance, he kind of, I don't know why, I thought of Count Bleck from Paper Mario.
Yeah, I kind of got that vibe from him.
Actually, fun fact, design-wise, he is a reference to Gori Washingin from Chikyu Sentai 5-Man, episode 33, Deadly Flip Turn, in which, guess what the monster was? Eagle on the back, gorilla in front.
Oh,
that's weird.
Nice.
Too spoopy for you.
Three edgy, five me.
Spoopy, spoopy.
So what's this guy's power?
Basically, apparently what he does is takes people's hidden feelings and amplifies them.
He says some shitty things about people.
No,
and gives them kabuki makeup.
So,
apparently.
What's really funny was, when it affected Leo, like, it didn't honestly do that much because he's already expressive about his opinions. So.
He doesn't hide shit.
No, he doesn't. And like,
he's a liar.
That's why for a bit there.
No, he's not lying.
For a bit there, everybody else was arguing amongst themselves, and Leo's just standing there with Tusk, being perfectly normal. But he's
commentary.
But he's got the eyes painted on his visor.
Oh my god, the eyes on the helmets were normal.
So yeah, you're just sitting there like he got hit by that, but he's acting completely normal. Because it's Leo.
You know what
right?
I loved?
Yeah, okay.
I loved when he tested it on the civilians and he had that couple.
Oh.
And it was just like, there was 10 other
love
girls
me? I love as much
of course
as you.
I love you. And he gets hit, but I'd rather be with like 10 other women. But here's the thing. That means that actually is true because it's not creating lies
yeah.
or turning them evil. It's revealing.
So the guy is
feelings.
Actively with 10 other women
Man,
at the same time.
Yeah.
So basically this monster is like the one from Shikenger. Where basically he...
Oh, yeah, where he makes people tell the truth, and that's where we first got the hint about Takaru's identity.
Okay, so we need,
yes.
this, we need this guy and like, put him in, like, liar, liar. Why is this happening to me?
The pen is...
Forgetting when I saw one.
You got that
okay.
down.
I have that movie memorized.
Or no, it's like the plan in Doctor Who, where it basically tells everyone, like, the truth. Hello there, I'm...
No.
And basically, I travel through time and space with my fellow companion.
I'm just picturing now, like, the team that gets zapped and, like Misao runs away because they speak openly about him, but then they're trying to contact him later. No, I really want to spend time with Misao.
I'm mad, I really do.
But, I'm such a shit!
But basically, Misao finds out that no one really likes
him. Oh, they like him. They just think he's, like, he's
annoying.
Really annoying.
They're
annoyed
by how negative he is, which is perfectly understandable.
And we got, like, this really funny scene of just, like, Misao transforming. He's just like, ah, and then just runs off.
There honestly Rails. Is something great about a character that physically looks that badass being such a bitch. I deem it Kylo Ren syndrome.
That's so true.
Yeah.
You know what? You're right.
You
are finished.
That is my favorite thing. Sorry about Kylo Ren. How people love him. I love him, but I have yet to hear anyone rebuke that. Kylo Ren's a bitch. No, yeah.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
Here's
you're
the
right. weird part. Like the monster's plan was apparently to like flip the emotions of the entire country. But that's kind of hard when the minute he, like, walked off screen, it wore off.
Sentai.
He's a shitty monster.
Oh, yeah, you were right about
he's trying to flip the feeling, flip the thing on all of the world leaders meeting for a summit.
Yeah.
Around the corner.
So countries will go to
like,
war.
I was like, why is Stephen
like
Harper there?
So
yeah, one guy looked like Stephen Harper. It was one guy who looked like Bill Clinton.
One of them was supposed to be Obama.
Yeah,
I'm sure.
Right next to each other was Bill Clinton and Obama.
Yeah.
I swear, they're probably the same actors from the episode Gaim.
Yeah, probably.
Fair.
But again, that plan wouldn't work very well because it would wear off the minute they got out of range.
Well, you know,
wouldn't stop them from hitting the nuke launch buttons first.
Are they going to bring the nuke launch button to a peace summit?
Yes. Sure.
Are they going to bring
okay.
Jason
back
to a peace conference? Yes.
That's true. Oh my god, that's what they do with, like when they turn this into Power Rangers. That, yeah, this is like
the peace
that's
conference.
That's really Jason.
Yeah.
Bill Clinton was actually Jason.
Pretty cool. Entire time.
Zach went on to become the first hip-hop president.
So apparently Bunghole's still, like, injured.
Honestly, at this point, he's gonna end up like Igor. Just fucking die.
He's well...
You started off cool. Just die.
Now you're no longer relevant.
I did like how he was just sort of, like, watching this episode.
Oh, yeah, because he's injured.
Oh, yeah, but I like that he still has a presence.
Yeah, just, like, thanks to him, he's the reason why, A, the blood game, like, got to a pause, and B, we still haven't figured out what the hell happened with Larry!
We will.
Larry!
Yeah, no. And when's Larry coming back?
All right, so...
Episode 37.
The whole scene with Misao...
In the finale.
The whole scene with Misao and everyone saying what they really felt about him kind of went in two different directions at once, where he started accepting their criticism of him, and it even at one point was like, it almost seemed like he's actually secretly a masochist, because he started talking about how much he likes them putting him down, and I'm like, Did Sentai just fucking put a masochist in the show?
No, but it's hilarious how, like, when they were spouting shit at him, like, he was getting, like, verbal blows.
Well, yeah.
Like,
oh, that was my favorite part.
Get out of here.
No, but then Tusk went all out on him, and he's like, but that's the me style that I love.
Shit.
And then everyone
usually doesn't express his feelings.
Everyone's
fanfic
on the me sound Leo. Fuck!
Like that scene though, where like you know the onomatopoeias are just flying at him.
Yeah. Well, it's not the onomatopoeias; the actual text.
I guess it was very Scott Pilgrim.
I have to say that I almost didn't come to Castranger today, and this isn't even a joke because this episode was so relatable that I was just like, oh no.
And then Castranger got sad.
Well, we appreciate that you mustered your inner strength and joined us anyways.
Emily, you're an amazingly adorable artistic human being! There, I said it!
No, not really, but thank you. That's nice. I just kept thinking like, oh man, this is like, whoa.
This is too fast for me.
Except we don't actually hate you.
That's cool that you have a Sentai hero to relate to, so...
Yeah, I gotta say, Misao is probably the most well-written and interesting character Sentai's produced in a while.
Wanna know why? He's human.
Damn.
That's a part
of it.
Which
is weird, because he's actually got 3 humans in him.
Except they're not actually, he's just
in his head. Oh, right, that was another part where, like, he's, like, sitting there, like, in his imagination, in his head, and just all of them are spouting shit.
That was the best part.
And just him with a straight face, just broken inside.
No. That's something that happens in real life. That's just anxiety personified.
Oh, my
that's
God.
And I think they put that forth pretty effectively.
I know,
make the jokes of the week.
Way too hitting hard, I think.
To make the joke from the Weekenders, did you go into that pink distorted world of yours in your mind? This time it was blue.
You made a Weekenders joke.
Hey, yeah, Weekenders is a cool show.
This time it was blue.
What was I going to say? I was going to make a joke about like having 3 Zoomans in me, but
yeah.
No!
3 company with Zoomans.
# crocodile.
Under the arms,
my
friend.
Sorry.
But no, apparently the monster has another trick up its sleeve.
Physical reverse eye.
Which I can
funny.
Flip you around.
Physically.
Oh, okay.
That's not really...
I mean, I can do that.
Yeah, just...
So how do we overcome this? Back to back.
I did that with a baby once.
You did that with
what?
A baby?
What?
No, basically, okay, I was at a... Okay. No.
This requires me to explain.
Guys, I swear this will make sense in context.
No, this will make sense. Basically, okay. Me and my friends, we were at a public pool, and we see a baby infant almost run into the deep end. So what I did, I picked up the baby, turned it around, and start running back to where it was coming from.
See,
that's a game of lemmings.
I thought you meant, like, you put the baby on your back and fought someone. I'm like,
right? I, like, did flips and jumps and shit.
That's impressive, bro.
On the other hand...
You straight up lemmings that baby.
But no, it's like, yeah, we defeat him, and then we get more fingering.
Yeah, Naria is still doing the fucking
speech
and still fingering the coin slot. Stop fingering the coin slot, Sal.
Just gotta finger that coin slot.
Stop it. Bad touch.
No. Sal, do it again, but say
no.
Kuji Tucker.
No!
Is that Kuji Tucker?
Stop.
I like how you're more uncomfortable with one finger than when now you, like, just full-on, like, grab.
Yeah, so all the zoologists, they all, like, take partners, and then they flip them around. And
take your partner, dow-si-dow!
Got some hot shark on tiger action.
Yeah.
That's some hot eagle in line action.
Yeah.
That's some hot shark and...
Hot elephant, rhino, crocodile, wolf action.
Four-way.
That's a four-way.
Anyway,
sure.
Beat the monster, fingering, Zord attack, they win.
What? More pancakes!
More pancakes!
And then Misao says the most adorable thing. Tusk, not to be offensive or anything,
but... As long as we're being honest.
I wanted to be with Yamato.
They are really playing up
Now, hang on.
And he just sits closer and closer to him.
Like the shipping.
Now then, take note. This was around the time when the ninja started to turn to shit.
And Zoroger's just getting better.
Sorry, don't jinx it.
No. Zoroger's around the same time, and it's still going strong. For story-wise. Okay. They haven't introduced any, like, dumb shit so
here's
far.
Here's the thing. I wouldn't even say Zavodger is terribly interesting story-wise. It's without a doubt, the characters.
It's Oh, yeah. The characters are what makes the show. It's a simple story, but that's what's all you need. I really enjoyed this episode.
I thought all you needed was drive.
It was really, like...
That was 2 years ago.
It was funny, and it had very good character development. And, actually, I liked how Emily put it. It touched on something real.
Yeah.
In which, honestly, I kind of like it because, like, you had the whale... Like, the whale arc a bit. And then it's like, okay, now we need to get back to the actual plot.
Well, yeah, again, which was there's still game. Not much of plot. It's just the blood game.
We need to get back to the monster of the week.
Do zany shit and make me laugh. That's about it.
Pretty much.
Although, looking at where the plot's going, it looks like we're going to have a thing where Kubar betrays Genis. And we discover more about where his shit... comes from.
What episode is this?
This is 32.
And next week, sumo wrestling.
All right, we got right? 12 episodes left then.
Next week, Leo sumo wrestles, and then Leo and Amu do a thing, supposedly.
Cat fight.
Why?
Neko Kami.
All right, Lane. Do your shit.
Well, this was recommended by K.R. Heisei, so one of our fans, so... Game start!
Nice.
So, like many recent shows, this series begins with Plot Rain.
Plot Rain.
And we see our poor protagonist. He's going to die. Gee, where have we heard that before?
Yeah, apparently Emma as a child had a blood transfusion.
But the reason why he had to have the blood transfusion, car accident.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, according to Nihon Subs, he got into a car accident. Maybe that explains what happened to his parents. Yeah. They died and he was on the verge of death, but maybe. He survived.
He beats Dragon 2016.
He survived because he sucked his parents' blood as they lay there dying.
I haven't
but
seen that movie.
If he did
movie.
That, he wouldn't need the transfusion.
That's the first scene.
I still haven't seen it. Spoilers.
That movie came out?
Yeah. Right.
What movie?
Beats Dragon 2016.
Oh.
You know what else came out? BFG.
Spoilers. All right. Spoilers. You just told me the first scene of the movie.
So,
he's an orphan. He needs to have no parents.
By the way, obviously, Emu.
He's a protagonist. His parents needed to go somewhere.
Clearly,
you can't have Batman without the Wayans.
Right?
Well, you can, but the episode ends up being boring.
Anyways. You can't. That's clearly pronounced emu.
Yeah. Emu.
Yeah.
He's a Zuman.
So I can see that X8's.
Oh my god!
It seems that X8's trying to pull some JoJo Part 4 bullshit, where it's like, oh, main protagonist got inspired to D someone from another person who saved his life as a kid.
They're going to make that joke in the Rider Sentai crossover. He's going to introduce himself. You're an emu.
And I will
Lane, I'm just saying, you can call it JoJo as much as you want, but that's like half of the fucking...
No, obviously.
Half of frigging shonen anime.
Yeah, but JoJo did amazingly.
Also, Osamu Tezuka, Blackjack.
Okay.
Look it up.
That doctor in the
movie.
I swear, Snipes' hair is based on that anime.
I'm going to say this right now. The 30 seconds that we see Emu on screen... already far better as a protagonist than Takaru ever was through the entirety of Ghost.
Wow, that's how I thought about Forze right after, you know, O's. Except in reverse.
Fuck you, Edgy's awesome.
Wait.
No. Basically, I'm saying, first 30 seconds I saw Gentaro from Forze, I already miss Eiji from O's.
Oh, okay.
Also, fuck you.
Right?
But
he just had that amazing story. Why go to high school?
Emma already is amazing. He's super, like, happy, carefree.
There's one thing I want to establish.
Clumsy as fuck.
Thank fuck they don't, like, establish a month in this. Because Ghost ends in April. Like, Takaru has ended his life in April.
Takaru has ended his life.
Or basically, the series...
Awkward phrasing!
Okay, the series came back in April. Genmu was already a thing. And so was X8. All they said was, it's 16 years later, so it's 2016.
Yeah.
That's good.
Sure.
For continuity. For now.
It's hilarious that, like, it shows him, like, it looks like he's, like, trying to, like, resuscitate someone. And he's like, come on, hold on. And then
playing
just playing a game.
I'm like, yeah, that seems about right.
And then just, yeah, nurse, supervisor lady, like, frickin'...
This show's version of the angry lady, non-power character.
Tugs on his ear and is
that's
just like,
only
you're
there
late
for
your doc...
She'll be
your
around
job.
Watch, I bet. And then when he drops his little portable Genmu boy, which is what we're calling it until we get a name.
Genmu boy.
Apparently, if we're led to believe what we're seeing, that's where the bugster virus breaks out from, I guess.
Or I think it was just...
He did it.
Like, I think
yeah,
it was...
it's all your fault.
In general, right?
Yeah, I think it's more or less like...
I think that was imagery.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
what
that's...
it has to be, but it just...
I was just saying, I was like, it was me. It was me.
And then
it
again, comrades are usually... you know, have the powers of their antag. They're just using them for good.
Which, in this series, is more loosely defined as just video game powers / viruses.
Don't pull the trigger.
We also get introduced to our villain, Pallad.
Pallad?
Yeah, that's his name, Pallad.
Well, he shows up a little bit later, but
yeah.
I just like this one scene right after Emu drops his game because it immediately cuts to nighttime and we get silhouetted shots of
yeah.
How I just imagined the script for this scene. Snipe, brave, a bike. Oh, by the way, Exe's riding him.
Right? I saw that too, and I was just like, cool looking rider, cool looking rider. A fucking motorcycle with eyes.
No, you know what? No, fuck it. Australia says, a gun, a guy with a sword. A bike.
Yeah, that's exactly
medical exit.
Yeah,
yeah.
Right? Like, I'm just imagining this.
Look at those eyes.
Opening,
this isn't
though.
Fives.
So like,
yeah.
Our leader, the tech guy. Funny one. Lame.
Wait a minute. Am I the unfunny one?
It said funny.
Oh.
Yeah.
But you ruined
no.
the joke, so yes.
And then, of course, as before, as we've mentioned, freaking X8 appears on the motorcycle.
Yep.
In what it's probably the gayest looking thing once you really think about
relax,
it.
Relax, I'm a doctor.
Dicks are touching.
The dicks are touching.
The dicks are
touching. It's pretty gay.
It's okay.
It's the bike is a person and the belt is up on the seat.
And it's not like Excel where it's just a person shaped into a bike. He actually transforms into an actual motorcycle.
And there's just constant vibration.
Yep. Right?
Good.
And just,
yeah,
just
there's an episode where double road
is on the seat.
Oh my!
Therefore,
to go back to Family Guy, Peter, don't. Sorry, it's the vibration.
Sure it is.
Yeah. But yeah, so we get introduced to our villain Pallad, and also one of the, I guess, Bugstar generals.
The graphite Bugstar.
Beautiful. Yeah, graphite.
Who's wearing the bug visor?
So yeah, everyone just immediately was like, "Oh my god, that's Genmu! That's Genmu!" No, the Bugstars come from the Genmu Corporation, so of course they'll have access to their
yeah,
tech.
Yeah, but that,
what is
but,
the bug visor?
It's Genmu's weapon. The little purple,
oh.
the purple wrist computer thing that also has lasers
yeah.
and a chainsaw.
But
oh.
according to graphite,
okay.
though,
I love it.
There are
awesome.
Bug stars in the Genmu Corporation's products.
Yeah.
So basically, whoever's in charge of making the products,
it's another smart brain scenario where the monsters are involved with the company.
Yeah.
Correct.
Nah.
Smart brain did it first.
Smart brain did it better.
Yeah.
Kabuto, there's just too many questions.
Apparently, Pallad either stole the Game Boy that Emu dropped, or has his own.
I like to think he has his own.
Okay, so do we know? Wait, do we know when X-Aid takes place?
2016.
Okay, 2016. The new game that's been in development for 5 years looks like absolute ass on a console that looks like absolute ass in an era where kids are still playing Tiger Games.
Yep.
What Japan is this?
You know,
right?
The shows can't ever get technology.
No, I
except,
know. But just...
Except because Bandai is involved in this, there was a shot during the flashback where Emu gets handed an actual fucking Wonder Swan.
Oh my god, I forgot about the Wonder Swan.
I was mind blown.
At first, I'm like, oh, it's a knockoff thing. And then I watch a video on YouTube. Oh shit, that's an actual
thing.
That's
a fucking Wonder Swan.
That's so cool.
But yeah, I was just kind of like, what modern-day Japan is this?
Where are we? Okay, so yeah, let's talk about
Wing
Action X, the hot new game. It's been in development for 5 years. It's a 3D retro-style platformer.
Yep.
It's called Mighty Action X. There is zero doubt in my mind that this is a reference to Mighty No. 9.
Yeah, but the question is, does Mighty Action X suck?
Well, we'll find out when Lane and I play it.
It kind of looks like shit.
It's like a fun size.
No, but get it. It's the sequel because Mighty Number 9, Mighty X, which is 10.
All right. But here's the thing. Here's the thing that I want to bring up.
Don't break my neck.
Here's the head.
I was going to give you a...
Here's the one thing that I want to bring up. 5 years ago, they mentioned a lot, like they mentioned it a few times in this episode. Something bad happened in 2011. I want to know what
Forza.
Whoa! Good night, everybody!
Ichi, walk now. Don't be topping that.
That was really mean. That was a horror.
Thank you, and good night.
Yeah, you're done for the night. You put in the hour.
The show lady is flipping me off, and I'm okay with this.
Realistically, though, it was honestly, whatever year they picked, there's at least some Kamen Rider that happened with some shit that went down.
Yeah. And since Forza was in high school, fuck it, that never happened. We don't need to deal with his shit.
So, yeah, so we've got a lot of theories in place regarding what apparently happened 5 years ago.
I want to say it's something that involves Genmu.
Because
think about it, he's the prototype. Maybe he took all the information and then he bailed. That's why they had to do it another 5 years, because they had to rebuild it from scratch.
Yeah, maybe the data for Mighty Action X got stolen in the form of the proto Mighty Action X gash it, and then Genmu had to start over or something like that.
No, this is what was really funny.
Food fight was 10 years.
We see the guy who I guess is
the head
official for the Genmu Corporation or something. Because what's the name of the chick?
Asuna.
Asuna, yeah. So she has the gamer driver, and the guy's looking. He's like, yes, this will be very important in helping with our situation. And, I'm just expecting him to just go, why is it pink and green?
No. You
honestly,
know, I want to bring...
that's what I... Oh, sorry. For
no, go right ahead.
Are you sure?
Yep, go.
I wrote, actual show notes for this one, so there were some things I wouldn't forget.
She's more prepared than core members. I wrote notes.
One of them
you always write notes.
One of them was the Mighty Number 9 thing. Mm-hmm. Another was... that their systems haven't evolved to 2 screens yet.
Yep.
And the last one is, this will save the world. Why does it look like it was made by Nickelodeon?
Yep,
there you go.
Yeah.
The other is that this season has, my two of my favorite themes ever, and I loved it so much I cried.
That's why I'm glad.
What are those two themes?
The reason
medicine,
why... Lane, shut up.
No, it's okay. Lane goes.
Let her finish.
Go for it.
No, I can't.
What are your two themes that you like?
I'm just going to say medicine and games.
Cool. Okay, cool. Sorry, Emily, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, I'm sorry.
Anyways, it's just why is it pink and green? Because it's exactly like Ryoma from Gaim. He has a sense of, Dan has a sense of humor.
Yeah.
And he seems to have if, because I watched the video of showing the Henshin demonstration for X-Aid or whatever like that. It seems like Dan's is kind of like a child at heart. So he seems to just be funny child.
So he's like Halliday? All right, none of you've read Ready Player One.
Nope. So regarding when the officials are in that office, I actually wanted to bring up something because that office that they're in has actually been used quite a few times in previous Rider series.
Drive.
Mm-hmm.
That was the office used by the Freeze Roidmude from Drive, the Police Commissioner from Agito, Chief Karasuma of Board from Blade, as well as Chairman Gamo from Forze.
Go.
They don't have a lot of office settings, Steve.
Nothing from Ryuki?
Nothing I could find.
No one likes Ryuki.
Maybe it was Zolda's office? I don't fucking know.
No, Zolda's office was his own...
His car.
No, his own.
His car. His car?
No, yeah, he was...
he lived in his car.
No, he didn't.
Business
that's what I'm doing.
But I want to bring up this case, which is actually about the suitcase that the gamer driver's in. As you can see, the gamer driver has a little slot in it so that it's secure in the suitcase. The gachet, though... Damn it, Lane.
You pressed it.
You fell for it.
Yeah, basically. It's just no groove. Yeah, there's no groove. It's just laying there. It could easily be broken.
Threw off my groove.
I'm sorry, you threw off his groove.
So since the main plot of this episode is that, some kid doesn't want to be treated and left in the hospital, so he runs away and
goes
after
him. He wants to go to the game release party.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. And the kid's name is Sota.
Sounds familiar.
Huh?
He wanted Gears of War all week.
Gears of 4 came out.
Oh, yeah, but he couldn't leave the house.
That's why Kevin got it for me. Thank you, Kevin.
Whatever, we do. Find out next episode.
So then we get this
got
funny...
it. He's playing the game.
Spoilers!
So we get this funny scene where just Emu, like, accidentally, like, jumps onto a cart and he starts going downhill and he's like,
slow motion, like, cutout.
Yeah.
That, I love the...
What is this, Poe from Kung Fu Panda?
If the show has more scenes like this, I'm gonna be very
I love
happy.
How much green screened it was when he just flipped off the cart and he was probably his actor was just laying there and they just flipped around his image.
Honestly, they all look green
screened. And then as he like falls, the cart nicks him in the knee and his shoe comes off and conks Asa in the head. It was just perfectly
like,
arranged skit,
plastic,
little skit.
Yeah.
Man, for being a doctor, he's very anemic, I think.
Like weak, you mean?
No, anemic. Like, you can bruise easily.
Oh, okay. Anemic means you have low iron in your blood, but sure.
Then you're also weak.
Okay.
Like someone who doesn't have a lot of iron and had dislocated his kneecap.
Hey, at least he doesn't have hemochromatosis.
That's true.
Anyways.
Or hematemesis.
So it's funny.
Or like, AIDS.
Or other big complicated disease word.
No, I specifically mentioned that because it's
cancer.
Literally the opposite of what they were talking about.
Okay.
So it's funny how the kid like picks up Mighty Action X as
oh,
if it's the actual game cartridge, and he's like, "Oh, Mighty Action X is just out yet."
Well, here's
Vacuum.
The thing: it very clearly says on it Mighty Action X. So.
No, but it might just. It, I don't think this is like the cartridge they use for the game.
Is oh
it,
yeah, that,
is it?
That's
you don't
definitely
know that.
The cartridge.
Anemia is usually defined as the decrease in the amount of red blood cells or hemoglobin in the blood. It can also be defined as a lowered ability of the blood to carry oxygen. There you go.
Science with Saga.
We'll talk about this.
So
but yeah,
let home know.
We don't know what the actual Genmu console's cartridges look like, so it could be.
It could have been that little crappy thing that Emu was playing on earlier.
But
no, that's the portable. That's different.
A little crabby thing.
So it's, like, the Famicom thing that like they released where it was like you can play it on the go.
Sure.
Why not?
So the kid is infected with the Bugster somehow. And it's at that point he gets dragged into the subterranean basement of the hospital.
Well, the kid is a gamer.
That and Graphite did say when he was in scene that a new ally will be joining us soon.
Yeah. So I guess at some point Graphite infected Soda.
Well, no, I think it's more or less like, I think it's more like an online video game thing. Like,
but the kid had no connection to games before going to the event.
No, but he was already in the hospital, though.
Which means they're infecting through the hospital equipment?
No, I'm saying that he probably...
He's
like,
a kid that plays video games. It's easy to frigging think he's been introduced to this somewhere previous.
And then they took him to
the
hospital.
Any of
the
other devices.
Anyways.
Well, theory crap for days.
It's funny how like this is apparently like a secret underground like section of the hospital, but apparently just Asuna let Emu just go down with her in the elevator.
Because she understood that he was his doctor.
Eyewitness...
Can we talk about how the button combo for getting to that basement is not that complicated?
What was it?
It's like the Konami code.
Not really. It was like four, maybe five buttons tops.
Boom. Easter egg.
I was saying, like, it was
everyone, next time you're in an elevator, try that button combo.
I'll do that next time I'm at school. Elevator stops.
No,
damn
only
it.
Four buttons on
it's just in another building cell was in blew up.
But no,
so,
can we talk about Kagami?
Yeah, I was about to talk about
it. We totally talk about Kagami.
So we meet Director Kagami, who is Kamen Rider Brave's father, and the Honganji of this series, apparently.
Oh
just,
my god.
No,
yeah.
I want to know. Is Kagami, like, is this Kagami related to Gatak
no.
Kagami?
I would love for that to be a thing.
You know, can we just say headcanon they're cousins?
Sure.
He's a good cop and a bad cop. And a doctor.
And a writer.
Just like you first see him and he's got a serious face and then just
bing bong
and just snap and he's like, oh my god.
And hi.
That actually startled me the first time I saw it. This fucking abrupt face change.
Oh yeah, take note, me, Ichi, and Lane, we all watched the Raw like Sunday morning.
Of course, like yeah, of course we did. We said we were gonna and we did.
And I'll watch Raw episode 2 this weekend.
Well, yeah, I will also, but that's because I'm really looking forward to Brave.
God, I hate him so much.
Well, why?
Because he's a douchebag.
He's the douche writer
the
of the series.
The 10 seconds that he was in the first episode, I already know I don't like him. Don't like him at all.
So it's during this scene where we meet the director that we find out that Asuna's mission is to find the genius gamer M, but also the director's son, Hiro, is en route.
So basically, if they didn't find M, would that technically make Brave our true hero of the series?
Yep. And I would be okay with that.
Of course you would.
I think that was the original plot.
Well, good thing she accidentally ran into him fucking pretty much at the beginning of the episode.
Well, no, she didn't know.
No, she didn't, but she accidentally, that's why I said, accidentally ran into him.
Yeah, it was a coincidence, and then it just turned out he was the one she was looking for. By the way, let's talk about the fucking stupid thing with his gamer name. His actual name is Emu, and his, like, online handle is just M.
Well, that's
real fucking creative.
Well, that's stupid. It's like adding four letters to your first name and basically totally gonna be something else. Oh shit, that's me.
Thanks, Autogar.
Or Ichidaga.
At least that's different than my actual name.
Yes. Or, you know, we could just take the first letter of your last name.
At least that has some creativity to it.
The audience
changing Evan R to Raven.
Thanks. Yeah, at least your gamer tag.
Well, I had to explain what we're talking about.
Yeah. At least your gamer tag doesn't mean Spangles in another language.
Yeah. Thanks for reminding us, Spangles.
Spangles.
What?
Lytrid.
Lytrid apparently is the Estonian word for Spangles.
And that's what I'm calling them from now on.
I thought it was a name I made
have
up.
Have we not told you that?
No.
Oh my god.
God damn it.
But yeah, he came up with that word just like out of nowhere. And then I'm like, we should look that up.
Well, Perka is apparently a Swedish name.
Perka.
Yeah.
Well, love us up, Perka.
I just named a Pikachu that, and then
Perkachu.
Yeah.
Perkachu.
In Pokemon Channel, they were like, name your Pikachu. I'm just like, crap, I didn't think of a name. I just the first thing came to mind, Perka, and then eventually that became my
Global Soft. Perkins.
This has been Name Origins.
Sorry, I didn't know.
Now in Pokemon Sun and Moon, you can Perka your Pokemon.
Dream of Mirrors Online, which was the name of my character in that game.
That game was fun.
That's also a name of Transformer.
I flew in a giant boxing glove.
Guys.
Man, when Emu, being a terrific doctor, takes his patient out of the hospital and takes him to the gaming
room. He's fine. It's just stress.
Am I dying?
The little bubbling alienotic creatures coming out of his neck. It's just stress. Let him play his game and he'll be
That's
fine.
That's what happened when you're
stressed. Am I dying? No, you're mighty. Mighty keychain.
Mighty's inside you fighting the final boss. Cut to Hero Academia.
Oh, no. Am I dying? I got this. Tucker shows up. Give him a hug.
No.
Icon shows up. Thanks.
No. No,
that's
but apparently,
Dr. Hugs.
Dr. Hugs.
So, but apparently,
that has to be the title.
Apparently, Emma is going the way of Patch Adams and just thinks, you know, oh, smiles can cure children.
Please kill me.
It's not that smiles can cure. His thought is, if we don't also make them smile, then we fail as doctors.
Oh, shit.
Which well, it's because that's what the doctor
no,
who saved
no.
his life did.
What if they get, like, an actual patient where, like he is going to die?
You mean they're going to bring onto the show an actual terminal patient?
Yes!
No,
not an actual terminal patient, but basically, like, a character where in which, like, there's nothing else that they can do. They're just waiting for him to die.
Or maybe that's one of the writers. Wouldn't that be interesting? Please. Like Beast, where, like, he always had the threat of Chimera eating him.
Yep.
I would be okay with that. Like a character who's like a terminal ill patient and then he becomes a writer.
That would be nice.
And he's a virtual reality writer. He's just in bed with the gamer driver on.
Exactly.
And basically
it's like Jin from GoBusters!
Yes!
There you go.
That'd be awesome!
So yeah, he takes him to the Mighty Action X launch event and you see Dan there and he's like introducing the game and fucking Dan's so cool. I love him.
He's Gen.
So much.
Good move.
Yeah.
It was real money.
Yeah, so we saw on like some card releases that it actually is spelled G-E-N-M, but it's obviously still pronounced Genmu.
Genmu.
So I'm going to continue to call it Genmu.
Yep, me too.
But we can't call him Racer?
That's
no.
Laser.
I've accepted that it's Laser.
It's Laser. They also had like Mighty Action X like t-shirts and like a little plushie of Mighty
plushie,
and I was like,
yeah.
I want that plushie, damn it!
Look,
me too! That's
what
I was
let's
thinking.
Let's go ahead and call it what it is. Mighty is the new Futokun.
I love Futo-kun.
Who's Futo-kun?
The mascot of the city of Futo.
Oh, God, we need to show... Yeah, you need to watch Double.
It looks
Double.
Pretty similar. It's just got a windmill.
It's this
face.
Little windmill, cute little windmill thing. I'll see if I can look up a picture for you.
Yeah, I haven't watched Double yet, but I want to. Sorry it's for interrupting.
No, it's fine.
But basically, hell breaks loose.
It's only 30-some-odd episodes long.
Soda turns into the Yellow Devil from Mega Man. The reference is...
No, it turns into a giant takoyaki monster.
Oh, God. Necrom sure? triggered.
I thought it looked a bit like a turd.
Yeah, I
was
going
to say
that
too. Cute.
It's got that texture to it. Definitely.
Futo-kun.
He's cute. I like him.
I miss Futo-kun. There was going to be a figure art to that.
Yeah.
Wait, what happened?
It just didn't
happen.
Production hell.
It blew away.
No.
So the monster attacks, and Asuna's like, oh, we need to operate. And now, here's where we discover what all those descriptions meant when they said the level one forms, quote-unquote, surgically remove the virus from the monster. It's straight up just playing the game and fighting it.
Yep.
As their version of operating.
Yep.
No.
He's playing whack-a-mole.
And, but you have to elaborate on this, though. This just proves Ghost made a fuck ton of money in, like, merchandising.
Well, we talked about how the Ghost Driver won an award for sales, so yeah.
I'm gonna say this right now. Anyone who fucking said X-Aid Level 1 is stupid, fuck all of you. He proved how fucking badass that form is.
I still think it looks like stupid.
No.
I think
he should have had a neck, but that's all.
Where is
your perfect for kids with
you,
no neck?
At the very least.
No,
finally, a Kamen Rider for me! So, okay.
No one in any 8-bit games has a neck.
So, quickly, let's talk about the transformation sequence. It's
really cool.
So,
it's a character select!
I know, I love it.
Puts the gash into the thing and goes, Gashetto! And then
one of the only things I liked about this episode.
So it does, like, a player select screen, and then, like, he sees the Mighty Action X one go in front of him, and he, like, puts his hand out to select it.
So, let's talk about that selection display for a while, because... If you pay attention, you can clearly see that Brave and Laser and Snipe are all shown on it. So this means a couple things. It's safe to assume by the fact that they're lit up and there are still others being silhouetted as question mark ones, we can assume two things. The gamer drivers are all networked to each other and realize that the others are all active, and those other riders have all transformed already.
This makes you wonder how the freaking Snipe guy is on, though.
Well, I assume we'll find out in level 3.
We will.
Episode 3.
No, we'll find
level
out.
Level 3!
No, we'll find out in Kamen Rider bonus stage. Kamen Rider Snipe. Yeah. The guy didn't film on Kamen Rider Snipe.
Damn.
The level selection thing, or the character selection thing, is really interesting, but it also brings up the possibility of, could they potentially choose to be a different
Rider
character?
Yeah.
I don't think so, because they have to use... You know, they use the cartridge.
I don't think it's... Do they need to choose to be... Can they choose to be a different rider? Will there be a rider for every game?
That's the other thing I wanted to bring up. The fact that each of the gadgets has a different sound for level 1 and 2 and level 3 means that there could potentially be another set of riders that uses the level 3 gadgets as level 1 and 2. There could be a rider that uses Gekitotsu Robots, Dora Mifa Beat, Jet Combat... Shakuriki Sports.
Upwards to 10 riders.
And Giri Giri Chambra. As well as whatever other ones for the other 3 riders we haven't
seen. Yeah, that would be cool, but honestly, it's probably just so all the toys have, like, equal functionality.
But here's my theory. I think that the driver has these different personalities that are generated as a result of the gadgets, but I think that they could still potentially select to be one of the other characters. What the gadget does is generate the level.
Yeah.
Because... As we saw with X-Aid, Mighty Action X generates this augmented reality level, which assumedly the gashes all do, which generates a level based on, like, action games, where there are these blocks with the coins in them, and it's safe to assume that when Title Quest gets activated, it'll generate an augmented reality level with the treasure chests that we saw in the news article, and then Bang Bang Shooting will do barrels, and it's safe to assume all the other gashes create their own variation on levels. I swear to God, when Laser transforms, it better be a fucking bike race level.
Yeah, I loved when Emu, like, activated the Mighty Action X gadget, and then just the title screen showed up behind him and started doing, like, the theme music.
Which
and
means
was, like,
all of them are going
to
do that.
Yeah.
The visual effects for the show are going to be amazing,
and
they already are.
I love how... I know this is... Sorry.
Go ahead.
I know this is jumping ahead, but I love how his Rider kick is just like full on 90s.
Oh, yeah.
He just has the like 90s graphics coming out of his leg.
Yep.
Sorry about the interruption.
So level one, Ex-Aid shows up, and the immediate reaction is, oh my god, what is this? What am I? And I just love, like, when he first appears, it's just boom. Boom.
He's got the Batman syndrome where he can't turn his head without turning his whole body.
I like when he was like freaking out.
You need a neck for that.
Yeah.
I like when he was freaking out, he does like this little like hop on one foot. He's like,
He like loses his balance for a sec.
And then just like when he unleashes like the Gatchakon breaker, I like that he puts like his arms up like a doctor prepping for surgery.
Yeah.
And then he grabs it and he's like, alright, let's fight. No, fuck you, follow me.
Bail.
Because according to Emu, Mighty from Mighty Action X gets more power with speed.
It's not just speed, it's just the fact that there are different power-ups.
Yeah, and the more power-ups he gets, the more powerful he becomes.
And, which is funny, because that's even more proof that it's just like Mighty No. 9, because in Mighty No. 9, you get different power-ups by defeating enemies and getting power-ups from throughout the level.
So Mighty No. 9 again.
Yeah.
Jeez, we're talking about this game a lot.
So... the coolest part of that fight was how like he did it like a wind up and then parried the Yellow Devil's attack in that one shot. I thought that was real great.
And then he wins.
I think you're real great.
And so he basically defeats it with he smashes it with the hammer and flattens it, and that extracts the virus from him.
Like, good, great, perfect.
I swear to God, I once sniped to like pull a data drain.
Yeah, really. That'd be cool.
Yeah, but then level two kicks in, where basically
Salty appears along with a team of turkey heads.
Salty is the
boss of Mighty Action X, like the first level at
least. He's like a sailor-y theme, so I guess like Salty, like ocean.
He's themed after like a dapper gentleman of some sort.
I don't know. I think it's just a meme joke. Just like I said, what's his name? Salty.
As I said before, it looks like the Blue Beetleborg just stretched out.
Except that red part wasn't his face.
He
had an actual head on top of that.
I like that Emu went like, Dai Henshin! Before he actually like pulled the lever.
Which is a Kamen Rider X reference.
Is it?
Yeah, basically, besides from setup, he also had another Henshin, where basically it was like, Dai Henshin.
Okay.
Cool.
And then we get what is pretty much a Digivolution.
He does like a mighty jump, mighty kick, and then like it's just the face it shows, and then like the level two body like kind of like forms
grows out of it. The exploded face.
And then Ichi noticed something.
Yeah, so there's something real weird in this sequence. If you pay attention, from the instant he goes through the display and through this whole level up sequence, look at X8's belt. It is both open and closed. Even though it should be open, if you look at it, you can see that the belt is actually closed, but then to the left of it, the gamer driver panel and the lever are also next to it where they would be if the belt was open.
That's interesting.
It's real weird, and I don't know why that's there.
I hope that they fix that later.
Dave, put a screenshot of as I'm describing it. So X-Aid level 2. And I'm starting to get used to the suit.
Oh, I love it so much.
I think
you do.
I don't so much like the design. I like what the rider overall is doing. Like
my
sentiments
exactly.
I like where this is going.
Yeah. So he summons the hammer again the same way and starts going to town on the turkey heads. It was this one funny shot where like he's about to hit one and there's like, wait a minute! And then he puts the pot on his head and then he bashes the pot.
Bam. And then he unlocks the sword and goes...
I feel like that was another Mega Man reference. You know, the Midors.
Oh, yeah.
What's the sword say when he puts in the sword
Gashin.
Mode?
It's still called the Gatchakon Breaker. It's just sword mode.
No, but what does it say when
it says Gachin!
Yeah, Gachin!
Is that roughly Tada, or was that a subbing choice?
It's just like every other sound effect, it's just an onomatopoeia.
Okay.
Yeah,
and then basically
that's what I gathered.
Even the word Gashat is just an onomatopoeia of inserting a cartridge.
But then... we get the cutest thing ever. He pulls out his gashat, blows on it, and then puts it into his Hisat holder.
It's called the Kimiwaza. As we mentioned when we talked about the scans from the movie, that was apparently something improv by the suit actor, and they loved it so much they went with it. And I'm glad they did.
Before that, though, I love when he's slashing down Salty or whatever like that. He takes the sword and just fucking jabs them with it a few times. Shakes them, and I'm like,
we see how the B button gets used. He actually, like, mashes it for combo attacks.
Yeah, so, like, two pushes and, like, one hit equals, like, two...
Yeah. And I like how they actually, like, showed him, like, actually missing a couple times, too.
Yep.
And then the rider kicks the fuck out of Salty.
It was pretty much just like Zarin did a funny video where he did like the whole like wombo combo audio to it. It's just like, but yeah, he like kicks it, does a flip, does it again, flips again to the other side, and then goes and kicks him, and then just goes, guys, you know, you batsa!
Yeah, so like right before he launches it, we get this awesome little like split screen with the logo for Mighty Critical Strike cutting diagonally.
Yep.
And I love that. Oh, I hope they do that for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yes, like, as I don't know if I mentioned on the show or not, but when they land the full combo, the belt goes, Kaishin no Hitbatsu!
And you just hear him screaming to his demise.
I fucking love that. For the first time, we have an Uchukita / Moe Tekita that I actually get fired up by.
Yep.
And then he clears the level.
Yeah,
he clears the game, and you can see the holographic displays of the other games, which means, are they gonna play each other's games?
Rival games?
That's how you cure the virus. You have to clear all the games.
What if it ends up like Smash Brothers, where it's like, oh, here's a cachet that includes all the games. That way you can use all the powers from
a multi-cart cachet?
Yeah.
Maybe that's like...
Action 52!
Maybe that'll be like their quote-unquote yes. level 5 form.
Yeah. Action 52. Some of them don't work.
Yep. Alfred and the Fennec? What does this one do?
So then they go back to the hospital and they show like the base that we're gonna have for the show.
Oh, no, you forgot the one part before that. They show off the other riders. In their human forms, in which I have to
Tiger's just watching and does his little bang pose.
I love Laser so much. Like I honestly love.
Is that just yellow fever?
No. I'm actually wearing blue today.
I had a feeling you were gonna like Laser.
Yeah, I love Laser so much.
He makes racing jokes.
It's like, seems like I want to join this race now. I don't know, I just love his character. I don't know, even though we only got zero of it, I just have a feeling I'm gonna love him.
Well, apparently he's a real jokester, so.
And we see Hiro in the limo on his way to the hospital, I guess.
A genius gamer?
Yeah.
I don't want to waste my time.
No, thank you.
Yeah.
So he's
the Nickelodeon.
He's the type of asshole who's going to be like, I'm here, you're not needed.
And now here's the part where I'm the only one in this room who actually likes her. Okay, that's good. So we find out that Asuna is actually a disguise for the real thing that she is, which is she's an avatar called Poppy Peepa Papo.
This is basically
the
show's...
I refuse to memorize that name.
This is basically the show's Eurosen.
Yeah,
pretty much.
I like her.
So she goes into the game, and then she's like telling him, like, oh, you know, you have to clear all the 10 games to be the super doctor, and then... Kamen Rider Ex-Aid!
No, that's stupid.
The other note...
You are stupid.
Missed one of the notes on my thing, is that the logo for the cyber... The CR,
the cyber rescue?
It looks sort of normal, but when it was turning, when it lights up, it looks like Pac-Man.
That's cool.
Sorry for
interrupting.
That's fine.
I love how you say that every time. You go, you're not interrupting.
That's just... Series-wise, it looks like... She's probably gonna be annoyed, but her mini series on YouTube, I love it.
Oh, the VR mini series?
No, she actually has another mini series.
Oh god!
It's basically it's about one of us, like a fan of Kamen Rider, going into her virtual reality as they discuss the episode.
Oh god!
That is so cool.
Yeah, and she's like, and he's like, I like your like human form better, but this is the real me. It's like, aw, I can't hate you. You're so cute.
I mean, I arcade game character come to life is kind of a thing.
It's okay.
But then there's probably like the greatest thing ever. See you next game.
Yeah, I love
but
like the transition.
Before that, did you notice that the game that when she transformed from Asuna into her real form, the game that she went into was Doremifa Beat, which is Brave's level 3 gashit.
Yep.
So Brave's gonna hijack her?
Maybe, I don't know. But we got a nice wallpaper shot of all 10 games that are like the plot games, like to compare them to the 15 heroic icons.
I know Evan's gonna fucking wanna get Drago Knight.
Drago Hunter Knight Z.
Yeah.
It's going to be interesting to see it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Drago Knight Hunter.
I can see the joke being.
Monster Hunter.
Okay, I'm calling it now. I'm calling it now. Final episode. It's going to say, game over. Or thank you so much for playing the game.
Try on a harder difficulty.
Now go and rest our heroes.
Continue?
No, go rest. No, go rest our heroes. This, the earth with a silhouette of like Ex-Aid just.
Thanks for playing.
Winners don't use drugs.
and then for like the episode,
it should be at the start.
And then for like the next episode, we see them like on like
head
described by your doctor.
They should use that for like the equivalent of, you know, at the beginning of animes like meant for kids, they have the please
stay away from the screen.
Adequate lighting.
Yeah.
And they should have it in a parody of the winners don't do drugs thing and have
the kanji written on the sidebars. One of them is, like, they're actually doctor. No, it's like, brush your teeth every time you have a sweet.
That's dentist.
Dentists are a type of doctor.
Anyways, Kamen Rider Ex-Aid episode 1.
I didn't like it too much. It was kind of boring.
Really?
I'm kind of on the same page as Cell here.
I mean, some of the video game aspects were fun to look at.
No,
but
there wasn't a lot of substance.
It was a pretty underwhelming pilot to me.
Like, this feels like something that, like, you have to watch, like, 5 episodes of to actually, like, enjoy.
See, I'm on that same note as Cell. I think there's kind of a lack of substance here. It's a pilot episode. They're trying to hook you. They're not necessarily trying to sell the plot yet.
I definitely think it's slower paced than other pilot episodes, but I think it's because they're building up to what something that could be great.
So it's like Gaim.
I hate that you take something like Gaim or Drive or O's, where you have these subjectively good series that hold that serious tone to them, and you start Ex-Aid and it's got these wizard ghost Forza cringy tones to them.
Yeah.
But there's still something that you can't help but expect from it. So you're like, I feel like this wants to go somewhere, but it's very clumsy about how it's going about that.
Yeah. Speaking of clumsy, and I know Lane and Itchy enjoy this, so I won't harp on it too hard. The main character. I can't get shit right, and I've getting into accidents all over the place. It's funny,
it's
right?
It's because he's new. He's young, starting out.
Better than Takaru?
That's not. But you should.
Yeah, but here's the thing.
A
trained chimp is better than Takaru.
What would you rather pick up off the ground? A rock or a lump of shit?
Right.
What?
I don't want this rock, but it's better than the lump of shit.
Right?
Basically, he's saying Emu is the rock.
Yeah. Emu is
the rock.
Yes.
Takaru.
Takaru is the pile of shit, Emu is the rock.
Like, you don't want
not
him.
The rock,
don't worry about my analogy.
Not the rest.
It's a good analogy. It was actually really good.
Anyways, what I was saying.
Can you smell what
I know Itchy and Lane both enjoy those kinds of characters, and this is just kind of this is just kind of a personal thing on my part. I really don't like those characters.
Let me correct you on something. I'm not a huge fan of those types of characters either. That's why I didn't like Daigo and Kyoryuger. That's why I didn't like Shinji and Ryuki. I don't like Ex-Aid, the rider as a character.
Yeah.
Everyone here is very aware that I'm in this series for Brave.
Fair.
As far as the pilot goes, I found it for the plot-centric, the establishment of everything. I was like, this is, you know, okay, here we go, we're here, we're there, I could take it or leave it. As soon as it got to the Kamen Rider bit, it was a little more switched on that I was just kind of like,
okay, this is interesting now.
Switched on.
Let's see. Get out.
Yeah, no. It's, as far as Emu as a character goes, for the beginning part of the episode, he's kind of started hitting a lot of my little issues I have with more recent Mate Rider
Bandits. I didn't hate Masked Form as much as I thought I was going to.
It's still... Level 1 still looks dumb.
I think Masked Form, we're going to phase it out.
But the way they utilized it in the episode, it was kind of cool.
Once we get into the higher powers, we're just going to stop using Level 1.
Probably. And the... what was the girl with the pink hair name?
Poppy.
Okay.
Pee-pee-doo-pee-doo-pee-pee-pee-doo-pee.
God fucking damn you.
Exactly. God. It's, oh my God. When I read the name, that's all I could think.
I knew it.
Exactly. It's all I could think of the entire time. And now I just want to see her straight up murder somebody.
Is that the opening?
Yeah.
But no,
also her incantation.
And basically, in her own little like side series that Nihon subbed, like the fanboy asked, "Oh, are we gonna see XA transform just straight into level 2?" And she's like, "We'll have to see." Which is basically what fly though. Yeah, they're just gonna like
don't spoil it.
You're like they're just gonna phase out level 1, like how they phased out saying that Gamma are invisible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I like the level ones, but I mean, I'm a girl, so I'm not the target audience.
Well, apparently you're part of the audience now because they've created the level ones specifically to target to people who like cute things.
Like me.
Is that your entire thought?
It's also a good part of video gaming, how characters are stylized in a certain way. Like, think of how in Pokemon games it has them shrink down.
Yeah, like they're very obviously based off, like, 8-bit characters.
Sorry again. Yeah.
Emu,
what are you sorry for?
Stop.
Emu in this episode, I hope he gets better.
Yeah, no.
He's at a hospital. That's where he's going to get better.
Here's the thing. By the end of the episode, when he transformed into Ex-Aid and he got into it and like he found his confidence right on the spot, I was kind of, oh, okay, you know what? That. I want to see more of that.
No, it's because he's a gamer and that's what he likes to do. So it's
no, and I understand that.
Yeah, he's an amateur doctor and a professional gamer.
That he was in his element and he went with
when
it.
He was about,
and that was...
Yeah, like when she yelled, the monster's behind you, it could have went two ways. Either A... could have just been like, huh? And got knocked away by the monster. But no, he knows these games. He knows how they work. He jumped up, flipped around, and fucking hit the fucker.
Yeah,
so.
That's the thing. I feel like later we're going to learn more about his alter ego as the genius gamer Emu. And we're going to find this other side to him and how he's such a skilled gamer. And that'll probably make him more interesting.
And also right now, he's studying to be a doctor.
Yeah.
He's not a doctor. He's
an intern.
Hell, he's not even like an actual doctor. He takes
He's a pediatrician.
Of,
that's
a pediatrician. That's
what
a pediatrician
is.
Doctor deals with children.
It's a kids.
Yeah,
doctor.
So by the end of the show, he's going to be fucking doing heart surgery. So.
No. Okay, he's not going to jump that far. That's like
four years
of studying.
I mean, the opening scene, like, of him and the older doctor that saved his life kind of gave me Blackjack flashbacks.
Blackbacks?
Yes.
Blackjack.
Honestly, Emu I like right now. I really do.
Yeah, so,
His heart is in the right place for what he wants to do, and he wants to save lives. He knows lives matter, and yeah.
We seem to be just going into this direction where everyone gives their overall thoughts on the show. So, as spoken, Raven spoken, Gar spoken, Lane, is there anything else you want to mention since you've
had
your segment?
I'm very happy with how everything's going so far. Keep it up, Ex-Aid. You're impressing me
Kevin,
a lot.
You said your piece?
Yeah.
Emily, is there anything else about the debut of the show and overall that you'd like to mention?
I just really liked sort of the thematics of it. I love games. I love the aesthetic. At first, I really like how their eyes actually have like pupils.
Yeah.
I don't know if you saw, but on Facebook, someone actually shopped Ex-Aid's design to remove the pupils, and you might have noticed otherwise, but the red parts of his eyes and the other riders are actually the compound eyes that most riders use. So there was actually a shop of it without the pupils where it's just the compound eyes, and it looked real interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry to interrupt you.
No,
go ahead.
It's okay. I can see that looking good, too.
All right.
You go first.
All right. So basically, like...
Sorry, sir.
So basically...
Everyone... I want to make sure everyone else has said their piece so I can do mine.
Oh, okay. All right. So basically, so far, it's been a mixed bag. The episode was okay, and some of us don't really, like, enjoy Emma at this point. Ichi, what is your opinion?
All right, so, yeah, as most of you know, I'm more on the positive side of my opinions on this show. I've said my piece about Emu and the direction I think he's heading. I'm real excited to see Kagami Hiro next week, and I've also got a slightly lesser interest in a Taiga Hanaya snipe. I'm looking forward to seeing where the show goes. The characters feel like They don't have much to them quite yet, but I have faith in the show, as I always have had. So hopefully we will see more development from them. I mean, it's not like we can get less development than Ghost had.
Here comes a new challenger!
Reigning from the capital, Mercury Caster Overkill! Here's my review of Kamen Rider Ex-Aid. Oh, man. I have so much to say about it. It's okay.
Yes, we harp on Ghost almost as much as we do for.
I think Tiger's going to be a fascinating character because there's so much doctor. About him that we don't know.
We're going to find out his dark past and why he's unlicensed and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. What did you just remember now?
Blackjack?
Mm-hmm. Blackjack? More Blackjack?
Like, fuck. Oh, God, he's an unlicensed doctor doing surgery. Oh, God.
Well, his version of surgery is shooting things.
Fair. But he's supposed... But, like, the intro... To him in episode one is he's the genius surgeon. He's an unlicensed doctor. Fuck if I wasn't already making enough Blackjack comparisons in this show.
Wait, what? What was who made Blackjack?
Osamu Tezuka.
Yeah, Tezuka did. Sir.
What is his art style based on?
Oh God.
Say his name.
No.
Say his name. No.
Never mind.
Blackjack's design kind of looks like Shotaro Ishinomori's like design.
Except you're flipping those two around a little, because one came way the fuck before the other gar.
Blackjack got inspiration from Ishinomori?
No, Ishinomori got inspiration from Blackjack.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, I'm talking about the grandfather of anime here, yeah. And the rest of you, and you're going on about Ishinomori?
Okay.
So...
it's a mixed bag right now for all of us.
The visual effects, absolutely 100% on point. The level up sequences are great. It's scratching that Digivolution itch on me, where I really love evolution sequences and stuff like that. So I'm looking forward to seeing more of those, especially Braves. So we will see what happens as we progress to the show.
Yep. I think that's it.
Thank you for having me on this episode.
Anytime. You are welcome anytime.
Anytime.
So, that about wraps up our show for this week. As we mentioned, there's no future topic because our discussion of X8 has been lengthy.
Well, Kevin, welcome back.
Great.
Will you be joining us for the season?
I should think so.
Yay.
We'll see where this goes.
All right.
But I'll always be with you in
always
the shadows.
We'll be with you.
You'll always be at our aid?
X8?
No, he used to be. I used to be the aid. Now I'm the X8.
All right,
so as usual, everyone, you can check out our crazy hijinks at our core website, castranger.podbean.com. Check out our recently established YouTube channel and our Patreon, and please consider pledging to help us make the show better for you. Check out the Cast Ranger Facebook page, where Dave posts memes, and tweet at us at Ixie Studios. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.
This episode of Cast Ranger is dedicated to our gloriously generous patrons on Patreon, Oliver Nilsson and Joel Maroney. Thanks very much for your contributions.